Hey everyone, Isaias and I were just chatting on something, and he had this really, to me, profound thought, and we were just expounding on it and discussing what it truly means. And so, start off if you remember where we first started with what you were saying.
Yeah. So basically, we were discussing a little bit of a program that we're creating, and in one of our ideas came up like, okay, what about if we let the user choose this, or if we let the user choose that? And then it dawned on me like, okay, hold on. If we just have a script that only has one action, so one task, and that's what it's going to do, the complexity usually is only in the code on how to solve that task, right? Now, if you add options in which the user can select different stuff, now you have to create a GUI because you have to ask the user for those options. And as soon as you do that, beside the task complexity, now you're adding more complexity in the form of the GUI, because now the GUI, you have to solve certain issues. I don't know if you want me to put it in context, like so you can get a clear idea.
Okay. That's very clear. Yeah.
Yeah.
And what I was saying was, I think I agree with everything you're saying, right? It was, look, something can be really complex without a GUI, right?
Yeah.
But as you add options, you know, it does increase the complexity. I wholeheartedly agree with that. It was just more of like, okay, look, like every time we let people choose stuff, like, hey, I want to choose between this and this, it's going to make it more complex to program around right now, right, for more than one reason. One is, which is what we hadn't discussed, was, you're spot on. Just building a GUI itself can be somewhat complex, right?
Right.
The whole thing also because it's not a linear thing, right? Like it can happen at any point in time, and that alone, right? But what I was also thinking was, look, let's stick with the first thing, which I forget exactly what you said, but we're going to give people options to choose A or B, right? Mm-hmm. Let's say we didn't have a GUI. Let's say we were doing something for me and I'm too freaking lazy to make a GUI. So I'm going to create two different versions and I decide which one I'm going to launch. That is my UI, right? It's just like, which one do I launch? That's really easy. It's stupid because it's like you're doubling the work. However, and I think this is where you're also getting to, most GUI programs aren't a simple branching and they do two different things, right? Like, because you don't want to, you want to interactively change what you're doing. Otherwise, you could have very different processes, which is not what you want to do in each script. Does
right. And yes, it does. And basically, that's the point that I was trying to make is that the GUI, you should only think about a GUI when you're giving a user different options. If whatever you're going to do in your script is just one task, and that's what it's going to do, usually with a hotkey, you're good to go, or double clicking the script is going to do whatever it was supposed to do, and that's it. So there are no options on it, right? Now, as soon as you tell the user, so for example, let's talk about this. Like, I'm going to grab an MP4 file, which is a video file. I'm going to grab a few frames of it, and I'm going to put something on that image, whatever. I'm going to create a GIF. So there are no options. The only thing that you have to do is select the file and do whatever it was supposed to be doing, and that's it. Now, as soon as I started giving you options, like, okay, you can select the file, but you also have to select the time frame where you want the images, the frames to be taken from. Now that's the time when you have to start about thinking about a GUI, because now I have to give you a little box where to put the file. And I also have to give you a time, a little box to put the time code where you want to extract the frames. Then that's my point. Now the complexity is that the best way to ask for that? Maybe you should ask for another way. Like, for example, put a preview of the video at the bottom with a little scroll so you can move it. And then when you scroll to the point where you want it, now you hit okay. And that's the time that it's going to take. You see what I mean? So now just choosing a file and selecting a time frame became a whole new thing in which now you have a preview of the video with a slider at the bottom so you could choose the exact frame that you want. You see what I'm saying? That creates a lot of complexity very quickly. and my point was, if your script is task-based, it's just one thing, you don't need to deal about with GUIs and stuff. You just do whatever you're supposed to do. But as soon as you start giving the user options, that's where the complexity comes. And as soon as you think about GUIs, that can make your code very complex, very easily. So you have to be careful with that part, right?
Yeah, I think you're dividing up on the where the complexity comes from, because one is, which is to your point, like I think we both agree that just adding a GUI makes it more complex in general. You know, like that's a given.
For the user is easier, right? For the programmer, it would be like
Now, what you just mentioned there was it's actually dynamically changing the types of options that you might even provide, because it opens up a whole new world of different ways you can actually give them options, right? Which
exactly,
which that's to me a different. Now it still goes to the heart of it makes it more complex, right? Which I'm not saying you weren't conveying that. I'm just saying earlier we didn't really talk about it's at least hadn't gotten to it yet, where you're actually changing the options available to what you how you present the stuff and everything, which does add you know, definitely more complexity to it. But to me it just gets back to it I mean originally I think you had said how the what was it the without a GUI the complexity is in the code.
Yes. So, how I was presenting it is that for me as a programmer, if you just have a task, the only thing that I have to focus on is, okay, how am I going to solve that task?
Well,
that's it. Now I don't have to focus on anything else, right? Because I just have to solve that one task. As soon as I have more options for the user, now I have to not only focus on each task or each option that I have to do that, but then how to present that to the user. That's the,
you know, it's actually, you're going to think this is maybe think this is a bizarre comparison, right? But to me, it's the Android versus iPhone, right?
Okay.
iPhone, they do everything they can to decide for you what is the best way to do something, right? Mm-hmm. And they lock it down. They don't let you usually like have a lot of different ways.
Mm-hmm.
Androids is like total reverse. Like they'll let you, you know, hack
and do almost everything. Yeah.
Right.
So, at a certain point. Yeah.
Yeah. So back to the non-GUI, the developer is deciding for them. This is the way we're going to do this. And I'm not going to make it. I'm not giving them options. I'm just going to say, this is what it does. The iPhone approach would be more of like, well, let's let the user decide which way is the best way, which one they like, and which kind of thing they're going to do this. It's not quite, but it is an, generally speaking, an interesting comparison.
It is. And in general, what you have to keep in mind as a programmer is that you always have to be mindful of the amount of options, because not only that increases the complexity of the code, it increases the bugs, because then you have to see how those options interact with each other. Right. And whenever you're doing the code, now some option might create a specific state in your program that you didn't take into account. And that's where bugs come in. So yeah, it was a very interesting topic about that. Yeah.
Early on, and this still, cause you know, I don't really play with GUIs a lot, but early on when I was doing stuff, if I had like let's say two groups of choices I wanted to make for myself, cause I wasn't sharing with people, but for myself, I'm like, instead of trying to create one GUI with two sets of radio buttons, I would basically present two GUIs separately. So I present one, choose, and then have
and it then the other one. Yeah, two. Right.
I was still linear. You know, I didn't lose that, and it was so simple. And then, like to your point, it wouldn't break because I got rid of that complexity by just saying, "Well,
by going step by step." Right.
But
as soon as you have one GUI, and that's the issue. So this linear process, it's easier for me because I take care of every single step of whatever you took care of. But it is a little bit difficult for the user in the sense, like, for example, imagine that I have to do five different options. Are you going to show me five different GUIs, like on each step? Right. You know, like that's going to be annoying at some point.
Well, I think the most important part is, what if I only want to do one of the five steps? If you every time have to do every five steps, maybe it's not bad, right? Because you're walking
Right.
When you only need to do one of them, you know, then that's a really
it gets annoying, right? So that's the point. So then that's where it comes. That's where the idea comes of, okay, now the complexity is how I show that, or how do I present that to the user? And that's where I would then not only have to solve the tasks, I would also have to solve what is the best way for me to present this information in a meaningful way to the user, right? It's double the work.
Yeah, we were talking about our Pour Me and Drip campaign, which is like for email, you know, an email drip campaign that we're working on. And sometimes it might be better where, like, hey, you know what? Instead of, how do I know I'm supposed to start here and then do that and then do that? Because it's not clear, you know, like in a flat GUI, maybe we should have tabs and kind of like say, okay, this is stage one. Here's stage, after you do that, then here's the next stage and here's the next stage. There's different ways where sometimes you do want to have a very clear path and breaking them into different, you know, sections. Sure.
Yeah, sure. Like, for example, but think about, you know, the installer applications. Whenever you open an installation, it just gives you the next button to continue to the next step.
Yeah, right.
That's what they're doing. Right. And basically, in a drip campaign, what I would say is like that flow can be perfectly acceptable when I'm creating a new campaign. So create a new campaign. Give me the name. Next. Right. Now let's import the emails next.
Right.
What is the time frame that you want for that next?
You know,
I could show that all in one big screen, but I could also make it step by step.
And websites where when they ask two questions at one time, and then it says you hit next, you're like, well, you didn't finish everything. You're like, well, what didn't I finish? But there's so much stuff you can't see it.
So many things, right? Yeah.
That's where they break it into separate things, and it makes it much easier to kind of go flow through.
Exactly. And that's one way. But then is that the best way for every single situation? No, I don't think so.
Right.
There are other situations in which you don't want to do that. You see? So that's where a programmer, and that's this is the part we talked about that a long time ago. It is like, it is good to divide a program into different specialties. And I would have somebody that deals with the code and somebody that deals with the UI. That person with the UIs will know how to do the best steps for that. And but if you don't have that, then your programmer should be able to not only solve the issues, but also look at the UI approach and see what's the best way to present the options that you have available in your program, you know?
Awesome, man. Well, thanks.
Good chat.
Yeah, we're going to be talking later.